Okay, so today I'll be starting with Raghu Audharyam. It is the second lesson. So Raghu Audharyam. Raghu is one of the ancestors of Rama. Raghu is the father of Aja. He is the son of Dilipa. He is one of the famous kings of Raghuvamsha. So Ikshvaku dynasty. Raghu is one of the famous kings there. So this lesson speaks about his Audharya. His generosity. So throughout this lesson, we'll be seeing how Raghu acts as a king. He is very generous. He is kind towards his seekers. And how he will help Kautsa, who will come in order to pay a feast to his guru. He would approach Raghu and Raghu will help him to obtain the required amount. So throughout the lesson, we'll be seeing that. A brief introduction to the lesson. Raghu would have completed performing the Vishwajit Yaga. So in Vishwajit Yaga, he would have conquered many kings, many kingdoms, and he would be performing a Yaga. In the sense, he will be giving away the wealth that he would have acquired through his conquests to the seekers who come to the Yaga. At the point where the story begins, Raghu would have given most of his wealth. Whatever he would have got, he would have given it away. And then he will see Kautsa approaching. Kautsa will be the student of Varatantu. So Varatantu would be a famous sage. And Varatantu's student will be Kautsa. So Kautsa will come asking for Kautsa will come and he will give the hospitality to the guests. Raghu will do all the prescribed hospitality. And after that, he will ask Kautsa the reason for him coming to the Yaga. Kautsa will tell that he had to give fees or Guru Dakshina to his guru. And he had hoped that Raghu would be able to give it to him. The amount will be huge. The Guru Dakshina will be huge. If we see the lesson in the 14th shloka, Kotish Chatastra Dasha Chahareti. In the sense, 14 Chatastra Dasha Koti. Chatastra Dasha in the sense 4 plus 10, 14. Koti is crores. Nanyakani. So 14 crore coins, gold coins, he had to give to his guru. Why he had to give, we'll see throughout the lesson. But he had to give 14 crores to his guru. Naturally, Kautsa will not be having that and he would have approached Raghu to ask for that amount. But Raghu at that point of time would have given away everything. He will be giving Argya in a mud pot. So seeing that itself, Kautsa will get discouraged and he will think he should not pressurize the king and he will go off. And he will want to go off. But Raghu will stop him. He will tell Kautsa that by some means, I will get you the amount. So Raghu will think and he will plan to go to Kubera to ask for the money or maybe conquer Kubera as well. So what happens then, we'll see in the lesson. So this is a brief introduction. Will Raghu get the amount from Kubera or what happens? Kautsa, does he get the fees? We'll see after reading the lesson. So this lesson is basically written by Kalidasa in the sense in Raghuvamsha Kavya, Panchama Sarga. Okay, so that is also given in the text. We'll start by understanding a little bit about Kalidasa. Okay, please start reading.
Kavi Kula Guruhu Kalidasasya Advitiyam Sthanam Advitiyam Sthanam Vartate.
Samskrita Sahitye Kavikula Guroho Kalidasasya Advitiyam Sthanam Vartate. Okay. Can you translate this?
Sanskrit literature, yes. Kalidasa's place is second to none. And Kalidasa was a Kavikula Guru.
Yes. So Samskrita Sahitye in Sanskrit literature, कविकुल गुरोः कालिदासस्य अद्वितीयं स्थानं वर्तते. कालिदासा हू वाज नोन एज द गुरु द टीचर ऑफ द क्लैन ऑफ पोएट्स हिज प्लेस इज सेकंड टू नन. सो द ही इज वन अमंग द बेस्ट इन केस ऑफ संस्कृत लिटरेचर इन संस्कृत लिटररी वर्ल्ड. कविकुल गुरोः so probably what I would suggest is try to identify each vibhakti, so it will also help in learning the vibhakti usage faster. So sahitye is rame, guroho is guruhu, it is like bhanu shabda. So kalidasasya is ramasya, advitiyam is ramam, sthanam ramam, or you can also take it as phalam, phalam sthanam phalam, vartate is वर्तते वर्तेते वर्तन्ते लट. सो दीस टू आर द्वितीय. सो लाइक दैट इट इज बेटर टू आइडेंटिफाई दीस विभक्तिस राइट. ओके कंटिन्यूइंग अस्य जीवन विषये काल विषये च बहवः अभिप्राय भेदाः सन्ति. सो अस्य जीवन विषये काल विषये च बहवः अभिप्राय भेदाः सन्ति मीन्स अस्य हिज जीवन विषये अबाउट हिज लाइफ काल विषये अबाउट हिज टाइम बहवः अभिप्राय भेदाः सन्ति. देयर आर मेनी ओपिनियन डिफरेंसेस, देयर आर मेनी डिफरेंसेस इन ओपिनियन सन्ति, देयर आर देयर. सो बेसिकली नोबडी फॉर श्योर नोस इन व्हाट एज ही वाज बॉर्न, इन द सेंस व्हाट वाज द टाइम पीरियड इन व्हिच ही वाज बॉर्न एंड व्हाट वाज हिज अर्ली लाइफ लाइक and where did he get his education, the details about that is not known. In the not known in the sense many people are not accepting one common truth, there are many different opinions that are present. So asya jivana vishe kala vishe cha abhipraya bhedah santi. Okay, so kechana kristashakat purvam prathama shatabde ayam asit iti vadanti. So some people say क्रिस्तशकात् पूर्वं, सो बीसी प्रथम शताब्दे फर्स्ट सेंचुरी बीसी अयम् आसीत् इति वदन्ति. सो सम पीपल आर ऑफ द ओपिनियन दैट ही वाज इन 1 बीसी. अन्य केचन विक्रमादित्यस्य आस्थान गत नव विद्वान मनीषु कालिदासः अन्यतमः इति द्वितीय चंद्रगुप्तस्य समकालिकः इति च वर्णयन्ति. So some other people tell that he was one among the nine mani, in the sense the nine gems of the court of Vikramaditya, and he was a contemporary of Dvitiya Chandragupta. Iti Vardayanti. So that is again a difference in opinion that is present. So some other people are of the opinion that he was one among the nine gems in the Asthana, in the court of Vikramaditya, and as such he was the contemporary of Dvitiya Chandragupta. Okay. Saptama Shatabde Sthitena Bana Kavina Swakrita Harsa Charite Kalidasasya Stutaha. So Banakavi was another great poet who was present in 7th century, who was in the 7th century. And in his work by name Harsha Charita, he has written something about Kalidasa. He has not only written Stutaha, he has praised Kalidasa. So what do we infer from this is, Ataha ayam nunam saptama shatabdat prachinaha iti nischiyate. So we can definitely conclude that he was before the 7th century, he existed before the 7th century. Kalidasa namna bahavah grantah upalabhyante. So by the name of Kalidasa, there are many granthas that are available. This part is highly important. Teshu raguvamsham kumara sambhavah cha iti mahakavya dvayam. So he has written a mahakavya, two mahakavyas. There are many rules that have to be followed to call a particular grantha as mahakavya or khandakavya or vesi or a nataka. So if you have the rules are like you have to describe one season and it has to be of a particular length, at least a particular length. Those are the rules that have to be followed for a particular text to be called as a Mahakavya. So he has written two such texts. One is Raghuvamsham and the other one is Kumara Sambhavaha. In the previous Turiya text, we had Kumara Sambhava as well and Raghuvamsham also. But in this text, we only have Raghuvamsham. Okay, Meghaduta also we had. Meghadutaha Rutusamharam iti Khandakavya Dvayam. So Khandakavya, he has written two. Again, all these Khandakavya, Mahakavya, all these categorization is based on certain rules. Abhijnana Shakuntalam, Malavikagni Mitram, Vikramorvashiyam cha iti Natakatrayam cha Pramukaha. So this has to be, this must be there in the answer if Kalidasa is chosen to be answered in the exam. So Raghuvamsham, Kumar Sambhavaha cha iti Mahakavyadvayam, Meghadutaha Rutusamharam iti Khandakavyadvayam, Abhijnana Shakuntalam, Malavikagni Mitram, Vikramorvashiyam cha iti Natakatrayam cha Pramukaha. So we'll see about the different names by which he was honored. Till here, any doubts? So this text, this passage speaks about Kalidasa. So what we infer is Kalidasa has a very prominent status in Sanskrita literature, and there are many differences of opinion with respect to his life and period of living. Some people say that he existed before in first century BC. Some others say that he was one among the nine gems in Vikramaditya's court. As such, he was the contemporary of Dvitiya Chandragupta. And we find evidences that he existed before 7th century from the text from Harshacharita that was written by Banakavi. And he has written two Mahakavyas, two Khandakavyas, and three Natakas. So with that being said, okay, these are the various names by which he is known. Kavi Kula Guruhu, so self-explanatory, the teacher of the clan of poets. Kavita Kamini Vilasaha, okay, so Kamini Vilasa. Vilasa is enjoyment. So he was known by this name. Deepashika Kalidasaha. Deepashika is another word for lighthouse. So iti ityadi vachanaihi enam kavya rasikaha stuvanti. So he was known by all these different names. Raghav Raudaryam, which is the current chapter, iti bhagaha Raghuvamshasya Panchama Sargat Udhrutaha Vartate. So this has been taken from the fifth sarga of Raghuvamsha. All right. So any doubts here? Right, okay, we'll move on. Okay, I was planning to have reading sessions, say sometime during Saturdays. So two classes per week. So in the Sunday class, I will read everything. In the Saturday's class, I will ask everyone to read one prose so that we get comfortable with reading. Only after getting comfortable with reading, we can answer questions and understand it better. So for now, I will only read the text. I will explain it. Any doubts, you'll stop me and ask. Okay, so that is the format I'll be following from now onwards. I'll break the sandhis. Okay, so that we can finish the portions as fast as possible. Okay. Tamadhvare Vishvatitikshitisham Nishesha Vishranita Kosha Jatam Upatta Vidyo Gurudakshinarthi कौत्सः प्रपेदे वरतन्तु शिष्यः अलीड ट्वाइस आफ्टर एक्सप्लेनिंग अलीड वन्स सो ब्रेकिंग द संधि तम अध्वरे विश्वजिति क्षितीशम निशेष विश्राणित कोशजातम उपात्त विद्यः गुरुदक्षिणार्थी कौत्सः प्रपेदे वरतन्तु शिष्यः आई रिपीट तम अध्वरे विश्वजिति क्षितीशम निशेष विश्राणित कोशजातम इट्स अ सिंगल वर्ड उपात्त विद्यः गुरुदक्षिणार्थी कौत्सः प्रपेदे वरतन्तु शिष्यः राइट तम इज द्वितीय द्वितीय विभक्ति अध्वरे सप्तमी विश्वजिति सप्तमी क्षितीशम रामम कोशजातम रामम उपात्त विद्यः रामः गुरुदक्षिणार्थी इज प्रथमा विभक्ति कौत्सः रामः प्रपेदे इज लिट्लकार वरतन्तु शिष्यः इज लाइक रामः So all the words in this first shloka are in prathama or dvitiya or saptama. Okay. Tam adhvare. Adhvaraha means yagaha. Adhvara andre a sacrifice in the sense a yaga. And that yaga is by name of Vishwajit. And an important rule to always keep in mind while reading poem is the adjective follows the noun. What best practice is that we have to group words having the same vibhakti in groups. So identify which words are in prathama vibhakti, group them. Identify which words are in dvitiya vibhakti, group them. Saptama vibhakti, group them. And at the end we have to keep the verb. That is not a hard and fast rule, but it is very easy and it gives good meaning. It is very simple to remember also. So following that rule, first I'll group the Saptama Vibhakti words. So which are the Saptama Vibhakti words? Vishwajiti as well as Adhvare. Okay. So Vishwajiti is the noun. Adhvara is the adjective. What is the adjective? Adjective implies that Vishwajit is a Yaga. So the Yaga was by name Vishwajit. Vishwajiti Adhvare in the Yaga called as Vishwajit. Tam Kshitisham Nishesha Vishranita Kosha Jatam. All of them are in Dvitiya Vibhakti. I am grouping them. So Adhvare Vishwajiti Tam Kshitisham Nishesha Vishranita Kosha Jatam. What does Kshitisham mean? Kshiti means earth. Kshitisham means the ruler of the earth. ओके अंद्रे राजा निशेष विश्राणित कोश जात ओके व्हाट वर्ड्स डू वी नो हियर कोश इज द अकाउंट और व्हाट कैन आई से द ट्रेजरी कोश इज द ट्रेजरी निशेष इज एम्प्टी ओके सो विश्राणित हाउ डिड इट बिकम एम्प्टी By giving away. Vishranita means bestow, give. The treasury has become empty by giving. Jatam is it has become empty. The treasury has become empty because of giving, because of charity. Jatam is it implies that it is implying a person. A person's treasury that has been emptied because of giving. Because of charity. Okay. So this Kshitisham, Nishesha Vishranita Kosha Jatam and Tam all are speaking about Raghu. Okay. So Raghu is the king. He is the person whose treasury has gone empty because of giving. Okay. Then what has happened? Upatta Vidyaha. Upatta Vidyaha in the sense a person who has obtained Vidya or obtained knowledge. Okay. A person who has completed his studies. Okay. So Guru Dakshinarthi. Arthi is a seeker of Guru Dakshina. A person who wants to give Guru Dakshina. And who was that person? Kautsaha. Further, how he was? He was Varatantu Shishya. He was a student of Varatantu. And where did he reach? He reached the Vishvajit Yaga. Prapede in the sense reached. Okay, so it is a litlakara word. He reached. Who reached? Kautsa reached. Who was Kautsa? He was Varadantu Shishya. Further, who was he? He was a Guru Dakshinarthi. He wanted to give a Guru Dakshina to his teacher. And further, how was he? He had completed his studies. Where did he reach? He reached the Vishvajit Yaga. Whom did he approach? He approached Kshitisha. Kshitisha by meaning Raghu. And how was Raghu? Nishesha Vishwanatha Koshadatam. He was like a person who had emptied his treasury. Tam is just an addend in the sense this flow of all these shlokas is part of a bigger text. So before this shloka also, there are many shlokas. After the last shloka also, there are many shlokas. In between also, there are many shlokas. This is just an abridged version of Raghuvamsham. So Tam probably had, Raghu probably would have been addressed in the previous shlokas. So Tam implies Raghu here, okay? So Vishvajiti Adhvare Kshitisham Nishesha Vishranita Koshajatam Tam Upatta Vidyaha Gurudakshinarti Varatantu Shishyaha Kautsaha Prapede. Prapede is reached or approached. Both mean almost the same. So both meanings are acceptable there. So Kautsa, who was student of Varatantu, who was a seeker of Guru Dakshina, who had completed his studies, approached him, the king, who had emptied his treasury because of giving in the Yaga of Vishvajit. And another good rule to remember is we always keep the adjectives in the front, keep the name at the end. In the sense, Uttamaha Ramaha, we always prefer saying Uttamaha Ramaha rather than Ramaha Uttamaha. Andre, adjective should come front. Adjective should be the prefix to the word, should come before the word. I'll repeat the prose order again. Vishvajiti Adhvare. Nishesha Vishranita Koshajatam Kshitisham Tam Upatta Vidyaha Gurudakshinarthi Varatantu Shishyaha Kautsaha Prapede. Okay. So, any questions? Arthi Arthinav Arthinaha. That is Arthi word. Vishvajit Vishvajito Vishvajitaha. Okay. I'll move on. I'll read the sloka once. Tamadhvare Vishvajiti Kshitisham Nishesha Vishranita Koshajatam Upatta Vidyo Guru Dakshinarthi Kautsah Prapede Varatantu Shishyaha Samrinmaye Vita Hiranmayatvat Patre Nidhayarghyamanarga Shilaha Shuta Prakasham Yashasa Prakashaha Pratyujjagamathitimathiteyaha. This is very nice. Okay, anybody can break the sandhis here? Anybody wants to try?
Pranmaye.
Okay.
Vita Pranmayatvat Patre Vidhaya Nargashilaha Sita Prakasham Vishasa Prakashaha Pratyajagama Pratyajagama
Correct. So it is Saha Mrinmaye Vita Hiranmayatvat Patre Nidhaya Arghyam Anarghashilaha Shruta Prakasham Yashasa Prakashaha Pratyujjagama Atithim Atitheyaha. So we saw in the previous sloka that Raghu would have given away everything. By everything, they mean he had given away all gold. So, in the this shloka says that Mrinmaye Patre Arghyam Nidhaya. So, Mrinmaya in the sense mud. Okay, I didn't tell the this vibhakti is right. Okay, saha is Ramaha, Mrinmaye is like Rame, Vita Hiranmayatva is Panchami, Patre is Rame, Anarghashilaha Ramaha, Shuta Prakasham Ramam, Yashasa is Tritiya, Prakashaha Ramaha, Pratyujagama is lit, Atitim is Dvitiya, Atiteyaha is Prathama Rama. All right, so Vita Hiranmayatvat, we'll start from there. Vita Hiranmayatvat. Vita is gone. What has gone? Hiranmayatvam. Hiranmayatvam is the, how can I put it in English? Hiranmaya and the gold. Hiranmayatvam is the ability of handling gold. Yes, that is better. So, Vitam is gone. Hiranmayatvam is the nature of gold or ability to handle gold. Yes, Mat. That is the Vigraha Vakya for this word. Vita Hiranmayatvat. So that is actually describing Raghu. So Vita Hiranmayatvat is Yasmat Saha. Vitam Hiranmayatvam Yasmat Saha is Vita Hiranmayatvat. So that is also, that is describing Raghu. So I said Panchami, I think. No, it is Prathama. Yasmat Saha. So Vita Hiranmayatvat is also Prathama. Right, okay. Smrinmaye Patre. Because he had lost all gold, he was giving Arghya in a mud pot. Who was giving Arghya in a mud pot? Raghu was giving an Arghya in mud pot because he had lost all gold by giving charity. All right. Shruta Prakasham. Shruta Prakasham is one who has read the Vedas. Okay. And Yashasa Prakashaha is one who is known by his fame. Pratyutjagama is welcomed. Atitim is Kautsam. Atiteya is Raghu. So if we put all these things together, Saha Vita Hiranmayatvat, because of having lost all the gold, Mrinmaye Patre, in a mud pot, Arghyam Nidhaya, Arghyamannu Nidutta, by giving Arghya in a mud pot because he had lost all gold. Who was he? He was Anargha Shilaha. Anargha Shilaha means Shila is of good character. Argha is a spot in the character. Anargha Shilaha is a person who has a spotless character. Okay. So Raghu is being described here as Anargha Shilaha, implies that he is of a spotless character. He was giving Arghya in a mud pot because he had lost all his gold. Further, how was Raghu? He was Yashasa Prakashaha. Yashasa Prakashaha. He was glowing because of his fame. He was well known by his fame. And further, how was he? Atiteyaha. He was a host. So here the words that imply Raghu are Saha, Anargashilaha, Yashasa Prakashaha, Atiteyaha. Okay. Pratyutjagama means welcomed. Welcomed. Okay. Whom did he welcome? Shruta Prakasham. He welcomed the one who had read the Vedas, who was well learned. Further, whom did he welcome? He welcomed that person who was his guest, Atithim. Okay. Implies he welcomed Kautsa. So this is Kalidasa's way of telling Raghu welcomed Kautsa. Okay. So the prose order goes something like this. We can start with Raghu. Okay, there are many, many interpretations. You can follow anyone, but I usually go like this. Anargha Shilaha, Yashasa Prakashaha, आतिथेयः सः वीतहिरण्मयत्वात् मृण्मये पात्रे अर्घ्यं निधाय श्रुतप्रकाशम् अतिथिं प्रत्युज्जगाम. ओके, द इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन विल बी द पर्सन विथ अ स्पॉटलेस कैरेक्टर हु वाज वेल नोन बाय हिज फेम, हु वाज द होस्ट, दैट इज रघु, because of having lost his gold, was giving arghya in a mrinmaya, in a mud pot, and while doing so he welcomed that person who was well learned in Vedas and who was his guest. Implies he welcomed Kautsa. Okay,
Anna, please can you repeat the prose order?
Right, yes. अनर्घशीलः, ओके, अनर्घशीलः यशसा प्रकाशः आतिथेयः सः वीतहिरण्मयत्वात् मृण्मये पात्रे श्रुतप्रकाशम् अतिथिं प्रत्युज्जगाम.
थैंक यू अन्ना.
यस. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, actually, had anybody seen this drama? This lesson was enacted as a drama long back. Raghu was Raghunandananna and Kautsa was enacted by Vidyadhar. It was very nice. So these dialogues I remember. So it was nice. Actually, if you had seen that drama, it would be very nice. Okay, so where was I? Yes, the second one. Okay, any doubts in the second one? I'll go to the third one. Sahmrinmaye vitahiranmayatvat patre nidhayarghyamanarghashilaha shrutaprakasham yashasaprakashaha pratyutjagamathitimathiteyaha tamarchagitva vidivat vidhignyaha tapodhanam manadhanagrayayi vishampatir vishtarabhadamarat कृतांजलि कृत्य विदित्युवाच. ओके, द संधि ब्रेकअप इज लाइक दिस. तम अर्चयित्वा विधिवत विधिज्ञः तपोधनम मानधनाग्रयायि विशाम्पतिः विष्टरभाजम् आरात् कृतांजलिः कृत्यवित् इति उवाच. ओके, so he has welcomed him. Who has welcomed him? Who has welcomed whom? Raghu has welcomed Kautsa. Then what did Raghu do? Tam archayitva, Kautsa nannu archayitva, andre he archayitva andre whenever, at that time whenever guest came, so they used to do particular rituals. So he performed all those rituals that had to be done for a guest. So how did he perform all those things? Vidivat, as per the rules, as per the traditions. Who performed all those traditions? Raghu. Raghu performed all the traditions that had to be performed for a guest. Okay, and how was Raghu? Raghu was a vidhignaha, a person who was knowledgeable in these things, who was knowledgeable in the traditions. Okay, so vidignyaha is like sarvagnyaha. We always usually come across these words, vidignyaha, sarvagnyaha. So that implies that they are experts in that. Vidignyaha is a person who knows his traditions. Manadhanagrayagi is a person who is the best among people who consider their character to be their wealth. Mana eva dhanam, a person who considers his character as his wealth, and among those persons the one who is the best is called as a mana dhanagrayayi. So that is also Raghu. So if we were to identify the prathama vibhakti words, it is vidhignyah mana dhanagrayayi, kritanjalihi, krityavit, vishampatihi. Those are the prathama vibhakti words. Dvitiya vibhakti words are tam, tapodhanam, vishtarabhadam. I think that's it. Arat is an avyayam. Iti, okay, uvacha is litlakara. So the prathama vibhakti words in this shloka speak about Raghu. What are they? They are manathanagrayagi, the person who is the best among people who consider their character their character to be their wealth. Vidhignyaha is a person who knows traditions. Vishampatihi is a ruler of the earth. Vishampatihi, so basically Vishampatihi means ruler of the world. Okay. Kritanjalihi is with folded hands. Person who has folded his hands. Krityavit. Vit is a person who knows. Whatever you add before it makes us know what he knows. So Krityavit means a person who knows what he is doing. Okay. So Krityavit is a person who is knowledgeable about what has to be done. It is similar in meaning to Vidhignyaha. Vidhignaha is a person who knows traditions. Krityavit is a person who knows what should be done. Okay. Right, moving on. So if you were to see, these were all the adjectives for Raghu. Now comes the adjectives for Kautsa. Kautsa is called as a Tapodhana. Tapodhana is a person who considers his tapas as his wealth. Vishtarabhajam is a person who is seated. So Kautsa is being described as a person who has been seated on a platform. Tam. So Raghu and Kautsa, they are the adjectives that describe the two. What happened between them? Tam archayitva. Vidhivat tam archayitva. Raghu, having performed all those things which had to be performed for a guest. Iti uvacha. He said the following. The following will come in the next shloka. So, Raghu, who is the best among people who consider their character as their wealth, who has knowledge about the traditions, who was the king of the world, who knows what should be done. As per the traditions, performed the rituals to Kautsa, who considers his tapas as his wealth, who had been seated. Okay. So this is just a continuation from the previous shloka. It simply says that Raghu performed all the rites that had to be done for a guest, and the guest was seated. He considered his tapas as his wealth, and Raghu started speaking the following. What did he speak? We'll see in the next shloka. So the prose order for this shloka is, we can start with mana dhanagrayayi, vidhignyaha. Mana dhanagrayayi, vidhignyaha, vishampatihi, krityavit. Then we can go to vishtarabhajam, tapodhanam, tam, vidhivat, archayitva, arat, avanabali, iti uvacha. Hige matadidanu. Arat in the sense near him or to him, with him. It is synonymous. So arat andre avara bali. Near him. So सो मारधनागयागि विधिज्ञः विशाम्पतिः कृतांजलिः कृत्यवित् तपोधनं विष्टरभाजं तं विधिवत् अर्चयित्वा आरात् इति उवाच. He spoke the following. Okay. Any doubts? तमर्चयित्वा विधिवत् विधिज्ञः तपोधनं मानधनाग्रयागि विशाम्पतिर्विष्टरभाजमारात् कृतांजलिः कृत्यविदित्युवाच. अप्यग्रणीर्मन्त्रकृतां ऋषीणां कुशाग्रबुद्धे कुशलीकुरुस्ते यतस्त्वया ज्ञानमशेषमाप्तं लोकेन चैतन्यमिवोष्णरश्मेः. अपि अग्रणीः मन्त्रकृतां ऋषीणां कुशाग्रबुद्धे कुशली कुरुहुते यतः त्वया ज्ञानम् अशेषम् आप्तं लोकेन चैतन्यम् इव उष्णरश्मेः. ओके, आई रिपीट इट. अपि अग्रणीः मन्त्रकृतां ऋषीणां कुशाग्रबुद्धे कुशली गुरुस्ते गुरुहुते यतः त्वया ज्ञानम् अशेषम् आप्तं लोकेन चैतन्यम् इव उष्णरश्मेः. इट्स् अ वेरी नैस् श्लोक. कुशाग्रबुद्धे, कुश इस् अ ग्रास्. ओके, सो कुशाग्र, कुशाग्र मीन्स् द टिप् आफ् द ग्रास्. द टिप् आफ् द ग्रास् विल् बि वेरी शार्प् आर् पॉइंटेड, राइट? So a person who has a sharp brain, who has a sharp mind, is called as a kushagra buddhi. So kushagra buddhi is the sambodhana for that person. So Kautsa is being addressed by Raghu as a kushagra buddhi. So that is another adjective for Kautsa that we can find. Agranihi mantrakritam rishinam, it implies it is shashti. कुशली, स्वयनौ कुशलिनः, सो इट इज प्रथमा. गुरुः, गुरुः, ओके, दे आर ऑल प्रथमा वर्ड्स. यतः इज एन अपेया, त्वया, बाय यू. ज्ञानम इज लाइक फलम, अशेषम फलम, आप्तम फलम. लोकेन तृतीया, चैतन्यम इज बेसिकली द्वितीया. उष्णरश्मेः इज षष्ठी. ओके, so kushagra buddhe I was talking about. So kushagra buddhe is a person who has sharp brain. So Kautsa is being addressed here. So kushagra buddhe, Kautsa, mantrakritam rishinam agranihi. Mantrakritam rishinam, among the great rishis. Okay, so if we can talk about this, okay, mantra implies Veda mantras. Okay, the rishis who recite Veda mantras, among them agranihi, he is the best, or he is the foremost, the foremost among the rishis who chant the Veda mantras. Okay, who is that person? Te guruhu, ninna guru, your guru. Kushali, is he all right? Is he safe? Api, and yataha, from whom? Tvaya, you have asesham jnanam aptam. Asesham, not small. Jnanam, knowledge. Aptam, obtained. By whom you have obtained a lot of knowledge. Like lokena ushnarashmeh chaitanyam iva, like how the world, like how the world obtains ushnarashmeh chaitanyam, the vitality from the sun. Ushnarashmi is basically the rays of the sun. Ushnarashmeh chaitanyam, like how the world obtains the vitality, or the vitality is the better suited word, like how the world obtains its vitality from the rays of the sun, like that you have obtained knowledge from your guru. And is that guru who is the foremost among the rishis who chant the Veda mantras safe? Is that guru Kushala? How is that guru? He is just inquiring about, Raghu is inquiring about Varatantu in this shloka. He is asking Kautsa that your guru, who is a great person, who stands in the forefront of all the rishis who chant the Vedas, from whom you have obtained a lot of knowledge, like how the world gets its vitality from the rays of the sun, is that guru safe? How is that guru? So that is the dialogue here. Okay, so the prose order. Kushagrabuddhe mantrakritam rishinam agranihi te guruhu kushali yataha dvaya asesham jnanam lokena chaitanyam lokena ushnarashmehe chaitanyam iva aptam. So that is the prose order. Of course, there are many interpretations you can have. You can change a little bit here. So if you want, I can tell the changed one also. But this is what I follow. Kushagrabuddhe mantrakritam rishinam agranihi te guruhu kushali api yataha dvaya ashesham jnanam lokena ushnanashmehe chaitanyam iva aptam. I can tell the second form of prose order also. That also makes good sense. So that is like this. Kushagrabuddhe lokena ushnarashmehe chaitanyam iva yataha tvaya ashesham jnanam aptam mantrakritam rishinam agranihi te guruhu kushali. You can put api at the end. So api is just a conjunctive word. Doesn't have any specific meaning. So both of these are fine, but this you should understand like a dialogue. So Raghu and Kautsa are having a conversation. Raghu has started the conversation. He is initially asking about his guru, who is a great sage, who was a great sage. So what will he ask? How is your guru? He doesn't ask like that. So he asks with good adjectives. How is your guru? Who is the forefront, who is the foremost among the people who have read the Vedas, from whom you have obtained knowledge, like how the world obtains its vitality from the sun's rays. How is that guru? This is just him asking about Varatantu's health, Varatantu's well-being. So Kushali is followed by a question mark that is implied. अप्यग्रणीर मंत्रकृतां ऋषीणां कुशाग्रबुद्धे कुशली गुरुस्ते यतस्त्वया ज्ञानमशेषमाप्तं लोकेन चैतन्यमिवोष्णरश्मेः अपि प्रसन्नेन महर्षिणा त्वं सम्यग् विनीयानुमतो गृहाय कालोह्ययं संक्रमितुं द्वितीयं सर्वोपकार क्षमम आश्रमम ते सर्वोपकार क्षम क्षमम आश्रमम ते सर्वोपकार क्षमम आश्रमम ते. ओके सो एक्सक्यूज मी देयर ऑल राइट अपि प्रसन्नेन महर्षिणा त्वं सम्यक् विनीय अनुमतः गृहाय कालः हि अयम् संक्रमितुम् द्वितीयम् सर्व उपकार क्षमम आश्रमम ते अपि अगेन इज अ कंजंक्टिव वर्ड प्रसन्नेन तृतीया तृतीया महर्षिना तृतीया त्वं त्वं सम्यक् इज एन अव्यय अनुमतः इज प्रथमा गृहाय चतुर्थी कालः प्रथमा हि अयम अयम संक्रमितुम तुमुन द्वितीयम रामम सर्वोपकार क्षमम रामम आश्रमम रामम ते निनगे. So again the conversation continues. He says, prasannena maharshina, by that maharshi who is very happy. Why is that maharshi very happy? Because samyak viniya, you have learnt it, you have learnt whatever was taught very well. Samyak is well, viniya is learnt. And the Maharshi is very happy because of that. The Maharshi here refers to Varatantu. So Kautsa has learnt very well, and that is why the Maharshi was very pleased, very satisfied. And at that time, if a sage is satisfied with the studies of his student, he would permit him to go back to his house. So that is what Raghu is asking Kautsa. So because you have pleased your guru, you have completed your studies, have you been permitted by your guru to go back home? Grihaya anumatah kim? So that is what is asking. Raghu is asking whether Kautsa has been permitted by his guru to go back home. Prasannena maharshina samyak viniya grihaya anumatah kim? So you can put tvam in the front only. So tvam. Prasannena maharshina samyak viniya anumatah grihaya anumatah kim is implied. Ayam hi kalaha, this is the right time. For what? Dvitiyam sarva upakara kshamam ashramam sankramitum te. This is the right time for you to get married. So that is the basic idea of this sentence. So marriage is described in this following form. How is it described? Sarva upakara kshamam ashramam. We all know there are, how many ashramas are there? Anybody knows? Four ashramas. So what are they? Brahmacharyam, garhastham,
vanaprastham.
Vanaprastham. Yes. Okay, Vidyadhar. So oh, that was Vidya there.
Yes, Ramana.
Okay, the four ashramas. Among them, the second one is Grihasthashrama. Okay, so let us keep it simple. It is Grihasthashrama. That ashrama is the one in which people are allowed to help the other three ashramas, including that one also. I mean to say, the people who in Grihasthashrama can help all other ashrama people. That is what I mean to say. by help, I mean to say, in case of, say, brahmacharya, or in case of sannyasa, if somebody comes for bhiksha, these people can give. So, grihasthashrama is the one ashrama in which, if they help any people in any ashrama, that is accepted. So that is what is meant by sarva upakara kshama. You can help anybody. That is permitted. Dvitiyam, that is because that is the second one. It is implied that this person, if he had been allowed by his guru to go back home, he is eligible to go into the second ashrama. Sankramitam is to accept or go into. Okay. So to enter into. Te. ನಿನಗೆ ಇದು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಅಯಂ ಹಿ ಕಾಲಃ ತೇ ಸರ್ವೋಪಕಾರ ಕ್ಷಮಂ ಆಶ್ರಮಂ ದ್ವಿತೀಯಂ ಸಂಕ್ರಮಿತುಂ. ಸೊ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್, ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ವರ್ ಟು ವಿಜುವಲೈಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕಾನ್ವರ್ಸೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಡಯಲಾಗ್. ಸೊ ಟು ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಡಯಲಾಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಘು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್. ಪ್ರಸನ್ನೇನ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಣ ತ್ವಂ ಸಮ್ಯಕ್ ವಿನೀಯ ಗೃಹಾಯ ಅನುಮತಃ ತೇ ಅಯಂ ಹಿ ಕಾಲಃ ದ್ವಿತೀಯಂ ಸರ್ವೋಪಕಾರಕ್ಷಮಂ ಆಶ್ರಮಂ ಸಂಕ್ರಮಿತುಂ. ಸೊ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಎವಿಡೆಂಟ್. ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್. ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಡಯಲಾಗ್. ಐ ಆಲ್ ರಿಪೀಟ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್. ಪ್ರಸನ್ನೇನ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಣ ತ್ವಂ samyak viniya grihaya anumatah api you can put there te ayam hi kalah dvitiyam sarvopakarakshamam ashramam sankrantum. All right, any doubts in these five shlokas that we read today? Yes, please start reading from 1 to 5th shloka. One shloka, one person. Or if you want, you can read how many ever you want. So please start reading.
Anna?
Yeah.
Anna, please can you repeat the prose order of the 5th one?
Yeah, sure. Prasannena Maharshina. Tvam samyak viniya grihaya anumatah. Okay. Api ayam hi kalah te dvitiyam sarva upakarakshamam ashramam sankramitum.
Thank you, Anna.
Okay, yeah. Please start reading the first shloka.
Samadvare Vishwajiti Shesha Pranita Kosha Jatam Patra Vidyu Kautsa Pete Varatan Shishya.
Yes, the second one.
Samrinma Yevita Hiranma Yatvat Patre Nidhayardhva
Nidhayargyam Anarghashila.
Patre nidhayargham anarghashilah kruta shruta prakasham yashasa prakashah pratyujjagamamiti
pratyujjagamatitheyah. Yes, pratyujjagama matitim atitheyah. Yes. Yes, the third one.
Tamarchayitva vidhi vadvi dhignyah tapodhanam manadhanagra yahi Vishtarabhajam
is one word, arat is another word. So if you want, you can break it here. Vishampatihi Vishtarabhajam arat Kritanjalihi Krityavit Iti Uvacha. So however you want, you can read. Yes, continue.
Vishampatir Vishtarabhajam arat Kritanjalihi Kritya Vidityuvacha.
Yes. Okay, the second, the fourth one.
Apyagrani Mantra
Okay, the last one I'll read. Api prasannena maharshinatvam samyak viniyanumato grihaya kalohyayam sankramitum dvitiyam sarvopakarakshamam ashramam te. Yes, I got it right. Okay. So we'll stop at this. The fifth, we have finished five shlokas today. I will pick up the pace coming next classes. There are 25 shlokas. We are five. So, okay. 1/5 away. All right. Any doubts today in today's class?